I'm sorry for the delay. I promised in video 71 to make this video about how I realized the thermal energy storage with heat pump at last Saturday, but was invited by an enterprise to stop halfway along the 1100 kilometer trip from our summer home to the winter home. They are interested to scale this concept up to much bigger consumers than a home. So I catch the occasion. I will let you know how it goes. As I told, I have to make a living and would like to do that with this channel. So please subscribe if you want to support me and the energy transition at home. Usually I remind you of supporting me much later in the video, but this is a continuation of video 71. So if you saw that and like the idea, please take 5 seconds to subscribe. If you didn't see it, go and look first video 71, otherwise it will be a bit difficult to understand this one. I would even say to see first video 61, where I dismantle a mobile air conditioner. Moreover, I saw that this video is becoming very long and want to show it in 2 parts. The second and last part will be in this coming weekend. So let's dive in. So this is the end of the pipe where I want to give the hot water. This end returns the water that is coming from the energized radiator to pick up heat or cold in the summer. I do this connection with the clench fitting for copper pipes. So again, we are going to connect this piece. Then this cone, this goes, and then this cone, it goes with the narrow side into this nut. If I give too much force, then I will cut my fingers on this on the extreme of this copper pipe. So in this way I can knot, and the knot will, it will tighten around the tube. I use plumber's hemp and paste rather than Teflon. The paste ensures that it is watertight and remains lubricated. Then it's possible to lose even years afterwards. So the best is that I take off all the other stuff. There are so many different connections here, you've seen. Adapters from one standard to the other. So now this goes on the nut. And here's the only inner part. And you need 2 pliers, but my hand is the other plier. Okay, that's very tight. Then we have the next piece. And as I remember, this the end of all is this 16 millimeter tube, which we use nearly for everything here. you have to take care because this radiator has also sharp edges. So it's a flexible connection. There are really many connections to make. Here you have already 1, 2, 3, and then 4 connections. What is the power flow from water boxes to big tanks, or from big tanks to your home or any similar situation? Flow times a constant times the temperature difference between supply and return. Example, 1000 kg per hour per 4.18 kilojoules per kilogram per degree Celsius per 10 degrees Celsius is for 41,800 kilojoules per hour, with 3,600 kilojoules equal to 1 kilowatt hour. You can also say that you have 11.6 kilowatt. This is already a nice power, even to bring a cold house of 100 square meters to temperature, but not too quickly. And even if two small heat pumps won't give you so much power, the same formula above, for where you eliminate the time dimension, so 1000 kilogram per hour becomes 1000 kilogram of water, will tell you that my tank of 1000 liter can yield 11.6 kilowatt hour by being cooled down from, for example, 45 to 35 degrees Celsius. And this can be done very fast because this energy is ready. So charging this double tank during hours of cheap electricity makes much sense. Use the same calculation for power flow to measure the production of heat by the heat pump. Measure the temperature rise during 5 hours if you work with the big tanks, or 30 minutes when doing it in the water boxes with much less water. Do this in a range where the heat pump will typically work, for example with a cold tank at 5 degrees Celsius and a warm tank at 45 degrees Celsius. For example, you bring 1 cubic meter from 40 to 45 degrees. You calculate the energy that's needed for this temperature raise. You divide by the time you need, therefore. For example, 1 cubic meter from 40 to 45 degrees needs nearly 6 kilowatt hours. If you do that in 1 hour, you have 6 kilowatt average heat production. That can be done by 2 or 3 mobile air conditioners that you transformed in water-to-water heat pump, provided that you have less heat losses than my prototype. If these heat pumps together consume 2 kilowatt electric power, your coefficient of performance is 6 divided by 2 is 3. But better should be possible by good insulation and warmer water at the evaporator. For example, bring the warmer water of the tank with stratification to the evaporator. Use a large rainwater container. We have in Sicily the traditional underground rainwater collector. Tubes in the ground, or in a self-made glass box that collects solar power, if this sun is available in the winter. I learned that it is not so easy to have a stable water level in the water boxes with sufficient water flow for a good heat exchange, but it must not overflow. You must have the confidence to go to bed or go shopping without the worry of water damage. gravity or just a closed circuit are the most secure solutions. Ice on the evaporator is a problem because the heat pump will not be able to take heat from an isolated heat exchanger. Ice is in a certain extent an isolator because it will block the water flow through the heat evaporator. There are many variables that influence the efficiency of the whole system. The best is to start with a reasonable setup that works. From there you can improve. Trial and error is the good company of many developers.
Unbelievable!
I had to close some holes of previous projects and Charlie gave me an idea. Initially I tried to close the holes of old experiments with taps of wine bottles. When I saw the material that Charlie ripped out of the pillows, I combined it mentally with silicone kit. I discovered that you can mix it together and treat it like a filler material. You can use that as a tap. Bending a pipe in a sharp curve of a heat pump or a water duct without folding it, because that will block circulation, can be done with a ring spanner. This model from Amazon had no thread, so not easy to make it watertight. Better keep at a lower pressure, so install before the pump. What can you do with it? It was a great help to see if water was flowing in the central heating circuit, just to check if the pump was working. There you see it. You hear the sound of the bell tower. What is the result? That is finally running the pump. Calculate the thermal power according to the formula above. A quick calculation help is, each 1000 liter per hour is 1.2 kilowatt for each delta T of 1 degree Celsius. The heat pump is from a mobile air conditioner. People try to get rid of these large noisy devices as soon as the summer is over, and they experienced that these devices are not practical for all situations. You can get them typically for under 100 euros or dollars. They are also rather easy to convert into water-to-water heat pumps if you accept that there is bending work to do with the copper pipes between compressor and heat exchangers. In this way, you can place them into water tanks. During bending, it's easy to force the connections where the pipes go into the heat exchangers, so that they will break. Then you will lose the refrigerant and your heat pump is broken. Moreover, during bending, the pipes can fold, and then the refrigerant will not pass anymore. This is the reason that it is not easy to put the heat exchangers directly into the big water tanks and need an intermediate water box.